And we're good to go, and as you would expect, Fnatic obviously winning the knife round and staying on the more favoured CT side here on Inferno. And I think, you know, especially considering the fact, the point that Thorin made earlier on about this firepower that Fnatic do have, and with Epsilon starting on the slightly less favoured T side here, I think it's going to be really important for them to get a good momentum going, get the ball rolling, and take this first pistol round here on the T side.
Well, Fnatic, whenever they get close to winning something, the reason they would lose it would always be because they throw away the pistol round.
Yeah.
And they always have. Fnatic historically have always made tournaments hard for themselves with their lack of pistol round success. So we'll see whether the curse, as Khan called it, will continue. As we're about to get this underway, Epsilon with a few problems going into this, but I think they should be all set. The two doors in the soundproof boxes are locked, which means this game is ready to rock and roll. When the analysts were talking about Devilwalk and his role as an analyst and the coach on that team, he was just stood outside listening, and he was just stood there with a big smile, like,
yeah,
oh, they're saying all these nice things about me. Oh, who, me? Oh, yes. They haven't mentioned how beautiful I am yet, but I'm sure they get on to it. And he was welcoming the praise.
Yes, he was indeed. But it looks like the action is about to start. We are underway here with Gfinity, as you said, and already action going down. Crimson is going to be the first casualty as Shock shuts him down with that CZ7 Viper. Looks like it's going to be a pretty fast speed push here coming in from Epsilon. Not working as of yet, though. Two players left alive. Shock is eventually going to be able to get a second kill of the round, but JW finishes him off. Olafmeister finished off Shocks there. But they managed to get two frags on the board. Unfortunately, no bomb plant there for the terrorists. And Fnatic get that all-important pistol round to start things off here on Inferno.
For JW and Olafmeister, that was just the easiest crossfire they could have asked
yeah.
for. They stayed static. They just fired straight into five players coming towards them. And somehow, none of them, we were in eyes on the Fnatic players, but somehow none of them were able to break up that crossfire and then allow them entry. So for Fnatic, the easiest of setups on that B site. So here we go. Pushing down middle will be JW. It'll be a frag coming in there from Shocks. And quickly, JW returns around and drops what was the bomb carrier. And we're down to just two Epsilon players. Kiyoshima will get himself the frag onto Pronax. And that's a 2-on-3 as Kiyoshima gets himself the M4 for his trouble as well. So with a CZ and M4, this is not a done deal for Fnatic, despite their man and weapon advantage. As Kiyoshima will come around the back, he's got a vital role to play. FXO just needs to sit, just needs to be big, loud, and make sure that they don't look for Kiyoshima with that gun. And in a second, Kiyo will come around and needs to unleash or unload onto the Swedes. Here we go, sets him up, JW will stop him in his tracks, and the gun picked up by FXO has now got a 1-on-3, which he won't get past JW to do. Fnatic pick up their second round.
Yep, they do indeed, which you kind of would expect, obviously, with the firepower that Fnatic have got with the more heavy rifles there. But with that said, Epsilon earlier on, they were on Dust 2, and they actually won the eco round after losing the pistol round to Nip straight away. So, you know, you can't put it past the team, as Kyanite talked about earlier on with one of the earlier matches. With these pistols that we've got in CSGO now, it's highly likely that teams can take those eco rounds, so it's great for Fnatic to keep that consistently and make sure that they can pick up the second round. So here we go, Flush is going to pick up the first frag onto Kiyoshima and shut him down. Nade's going down just to stop any pushes from the T, so we're heading towards mid. Pronax gets the second. Looks like they're all going to converge any few seconds here. Shocks eventually able to pick up one, but that was a very quick round indeed, with hardly any time gone down on the clock. Fnatic extend their lead to 3-0. And this is the most important time here now, I think, for Epsilon, really, in these early parts of the stages of the game, really. As soon as you lose those first three rounds and are able to buy up and get those rifles, it's so important to get the ball rolling and get that first round on the board.
First buy round for Epsilon, indeed, vital for them to see what they can test down against this Fnatic side. It'll be Kiyoshima to lead the charge as he goes just on that foot of banana and will lead the bomb there as well. So Olafmeister hand push down banana with the help of JW. The pair of them have been Crims with them. A pair of them were the ones that set up, it was JW with Olaf who set up on B earlier, and they allowed just nothing to get past. And Olaf can leave Crims down on the B site and say, on the banana walkway and just say, you know what, you go there. If you're not dead, that means I can rotate all the way around through spawn, and he will join up at A. So there are 1-4, and Flusher will be the man to join. And they'll stick 4 on A. And Crims plays the vital role here. He's down there. He has all the vision. Doesn't say that B is absolutely fine. He got plenty of time. Sit in deep at A. And that is what Fnatic will do. They have a man up, FXO is downed, and it was Flusher that picked up that frag, and now you will see Fnatic waiting and waiting and waiting, and for Epsilon, they've taken a fair amount of time to get this one going, and Fnatic have been ready and waiting for them, pushing out his Flusher. Oh, unable to finish off the job on Kiyoshima. Did some damage, but not a whole lot. Pronax and JW, though, will help themselves to a frag, and Epsilon will be down to just a 2-on-4. Now as JW gets himself the frag onto Shox, it's all on Kiyoshima. JW finishes off his breakfast. It's 4-0 for Fnatic.
Yeah, it is indeed, and we talked before that round started about how it was crucial there for the terrorists to be able to get that round on the board, and unfortunately they weren't able to do so. And we can see their economy there not sitting pretty whatsoever. So by the looks of things, 4ZZ75s is going to be the name of the game for them, 5 even actually. So we'll see what damage they can do with that. Of course, we can't underestimate the power of that little pistol there. One of my friends in the UK scene actually classes it as the third most powerful assault rifle, which is just hilarious, obviously joke there. Flush is going to start things off here though in round number 5 as SF is the first casualty. Pronax backing away from mid there, just making sure that he's not going to play too silly. P5 at corners, another casualty goes down. FXO does pick up a frag onto Pronax, but is it going to be enough to start things off here? JW knocked down to 4 HP. There's a 4-on-2 situation here, of course, in favor of the CTs, but unfortunately, I don't think that the terrorists are going to be able to get much further here than this position where Flusher is in a lovely spot, and he has spotted that player coming out from apartments. As soon as I say that, though, I call it wrong as FXO gets his second frag with that CZ75 of the round, and the combination of those two T players was only 26 HP. Now it's all going to be left up once again to Kiyoshima on 6 HP, and he's got 3 angry Swedes to try and get through. Not going to happen. Olaf Meister finishes him off, and Epsilon still to get around on the board here. It's starting to get a bit scary in some essences for them. They need to get something going soon.
It is 5-0 for Fnatic as the Swedes are looking good by round here for Epsilon, and they will put FXO with an AWP. What Epsilon need is something they haven't had on since the pistol, is the opening frag. They need the entry, and then they can allow Shox to pick off people as they move around. Then they can give Shox that advantage, you know, that freedom to say, we've got the man advantage, go and be the artist of this team. But that hasn't happened, again, with Olaf Meister here, they know, they've got all the information in the world, with Olaf Meister just saying, no one coming B, no one coming B, no one coming B. And so they can sit deep in A and wait for that to happen, as the bomb will actually rotate round, and they are going to take a peek at that banana walkway. And it's Crims who's sat far down there now. And they're using no nades, there's nothing that's pushed Fnatic back on this banana walkway. Nothing has prevented Olaf and Crims from going and doing exactly what they're doing now, which is sit advanced on that site. Yes, they know they're there, but the bomb is moving in towards the A site now as a four-man Epsilon attack will edge in. FXO with the AWP is going to play a big role to try and carve open a shot for the French side as he will edge his way around the corner. Nothing to see for him. First opportunity comes, but he's flashed instantly and has to quickly retreat back as JW comes in. Kiyoshima is going to get one frag on the board, but there are 3 from Fnatic there. Flusher and Olaf Meister doing the damage. It's all on SF now. 1-on-4, and Fnatic, oh, this is utter destruction from them in the opening 6 rounds.
Oh, it is indeed. And of course, the only frag that they picked up there was onto JW. But he's sitting pretty on almost $14,000 with the economy there. So Fnatic on that CT side are very, very happy with their money situation. And the terrorists look like they are going to force things up. But their economy is not sitting pretty whatsoever here. So 6-0 is your score, obviously, as you can see at the top. And it's about time now that Shox and the rest of the French guys from Epsilon show us what they're made of. They had a great performance earlier on against NiP. They were 11-4 down, as you will all know, and somehow managed to come back on the T side and take it 16-14. They played phenomenally overall. They need to start getting those scores on the go here if they want to come back into this game anytime soon. So into round number 7 we go. Still 1 minute 17 seconds left on the clock, so plenty of time here for the T's to play with, and no casualties as of yet. You can see once again how aggressive it's going to be. Crims down there, he's on banana, and he's just keeping control of it. Of course, Tossbot here has been mentioning that so many times now, making sure that he knows where all of that information is coming from there towards banana, and relaying that to the rest of his team. Now JW starting to peek towards apartments, not going to do anything silly though. And and we've still not got any casualties here, so very, very slow indeed. I would have thought this push would be coming in anytime soon, and you can see a couple of those T players starting to rotate slightly back towards mid, over towards Banana, but as soon as I do say that, they've now made their way back up, so an incredibly slow round. And I'm not quite sure how it's going to play out as of yet. Rush is going to get the first frag, though. That's important. FXO does respond with that CZ75, and he's going to be rewarded by picking up an AK-47 for his trouble there. Shox gets another one, and here we go. The push onto the A site comes in. JW responds onto SF. Pronax is going to try and help him out there up on the balcony. Shots go down through the smoke, but Shox has really started to come into his own here. He's starting to warm up on the main stage in London. Kiyoshima picks up fourth frag for the terrorists in this round, and it's all going to be left up to JW. We know how strong this player is, but I'm not quite sure if he's going to be strong enough here to do a 1v3 retake and defuse the bomb in time. And confirmation of that, the terrorists finally get their first round on the board. And is this the start of an Epsilon comeback? We're about to find out.
Well, I wanted to talk about Olafmeister down on B again, because they're not even nading or pushing him back. Yeah. They expected a B rush that round, and so they sat really deep with three players in on the B site to begin with. And then once they realized that wasn't coming, once there was no nades tossed up, up on the walkway, they're like, okay, we can edge Olafmeister down. But they were very slow to bring the other players over towards A. Didn't matter. Epsilon themselves were pretty slow to get there. But the entry fragging from Epsilon was just exceptional. Now, big round this for Epsilon, 6-1. And here we go, action coming for Crims. They get themselves two frags. Olafmeister has the third. And again, it's those two players that we're talking about, the new boys on the Fnatic side, who have done the damage. But if Epsilon lose this round, the money system will just be right against them, as they've it'll reset and they'll find themselves in a painful spot. And that is why Shox and FXO are just sitting deep. This is a real tricky point for Epsilon. They've got to go up against five players, but what they're really facing is a six-round money reset, as Crims will pick it off the frag on Shox. And now FXO with the AWP is just hoping for something. And that'll be exactly what he wanted. Someone to give him an easy kill, and it'll be JW that walks onto his crosshair, and he will dart around. And he's got plenty of nades. He would happily wait 30 seconds, you would think, but he has to make himself somewhat somewhat big in those 30 seconds, or they will just close him out and spawn. And they Fnatic, do not want to leave an AWP in the game, and they probably don't know quite how many nades he has as well. They don't want to leave any of that in the game. And FXO is not at all playing safe. He had 17 seconds to go, and he just decided he would push in. Whether Fnatic would have rushed him, regardless, it is Fnatic 7, Epsilon 1.
It is indeed, and once again, it looks like it's going to be another eco here for the Frenchmen of Epsilon. Not got much money in the bank whatsoever, so it's going to be another case of those CZs coming into play. And we've got Flusher with that AWP on the CT side here, and we'll see what work he can do with that weapon. So Fnatic, they're going to be very happy with how they've performed so far. But I wouldn't put it past Epsilon to come back into this game. Although they're not performing up to the standards that we'd love so far, you can't put it past them, especially after that result we saw earlier on in the day against Ninjas in Pyjamas. Here in round number 9 though, GMX already the first one to go down here with a lovely shot coming in with the AWP. MJW it was. He's got that CZ75 out, gonna shut down FXO. So that's another player down there, making it a 5-on-3 situation. And we can see that that bomb is stacked up over towards apartments once again. And you know, it's just becoming more and more of an occurrence here that the terrorists are really making their way over towards this A site, and we saw them get some really nice entry frags and take that round earlier on. I believe it was in round 7. But since then, they've just not really been able to do much work on this A bomb site. JW here starting to get some good shots in, and he's going to get takedown shots. Flush to finish things off, and that's 8-1 now in favor of Fnatic.
It was an eco round, so you know what the analysis I'm about to, you know, or what I'm about to say is not really fair on Epsilon, but it was 1-1, and they had no nades to move the Swedes.
No.
So they were just sat in pretty standard positions where they would come out. They're only on that A site. They're only kind of 2.5 entries that they can go through. And they just sat there, and they happily watched the players come towards them. So another big round for Epsilon here, and big only because that scoreboard is so much against them. JW extending all the way down here with that AWP, and he will lie in wait. Oh, gets a warning shot against him, misses his second one, but will pull back, and here you go. Pronax is going to happily come in. JW in the end was the bait. He was the wiggling worm on the end of that fishing rod, and Pronax was the human waiting to cook him. As that analogy runs out pretty quickly. As we're on board with Pronex, who will push in. And it's a man to the good for Fnatic. But trading JW, using JW as bait, one of the strongest players in the game, is certainly a ballsy move. As they do have FXO with the bomb and the AWP as well to play a big role. In towards A, they will go. And Flusher is aware of that, as he will watch FXO make the crossover, do some damage to those players, but not much. They'll get across. Flusher is down, and in towards A they go. Who's in there for Fnatic? There is gonna make their way through CT spawn. Just try and see whether anyone from Fnatic makes a rotation. They can cut them off at 3-on-1. Hasn't happened. Pronex still sat deep in A. Will be saying, no one here just yet, as he lies in wait, because here comes the bomb now. Pronex is going to make the first frag. It'll be Kirishima that goes down. Who's he got next? Looks across towards the side, and Olaf Meister comes in to help him out, and Fnatic will retake. And from a 3-on-what-was-3 situation, Epsilon able only to get the bomb down and no frags.
No frags indeed. And that player earlier on, you know, calling out JW being the bait there, that was such a crucial part of the round there. Although the Epsilon squad were able to even up the situation and get two frags after that to make it 3 versus 3, just those opening two frags there that we saw happen in apartments was huge, because that completely could have changed things up for the terrorist squad there. They were able to get the bomb down, as you did point out, but that wasn't quite enough. Three quick frags in succession for Fnatic shut down the 10th round, and we're into round number 11, and it's a definite force by here coming in. You can see, you know, and kind of I always spots this out, and I agree with him. As soon as you know that their Galils are starting to come into play on the terror side, you know that they're struggling for money indeed, and they're trying to just get as many rounds on the board here. We're not far off the end of the first half, and if Epsilon don't do something quickly, this game is going to get further and further away from them, and that's of course not what they want, especially after such a strong result earlier on against NiP. In come the flashes though. Is this going to be a quick round? In they go. Flush is going to try and deflect some of that aggression coming in from the French side. And we can already see that GMX is down to 7 HP. SF does get the first entry frag here, and this is such a crucial part here for Epsilon, getting these entry frags. Flush is going to respond. He gets two. Is he going to get the hat trick? Yes, he does. All in the hands of Shox in a 1-on-3. And they just shut them down there. They were in such lovely position from Fnatic. Shox does get one, so
this isn't over.
No, it's definitely not over. Now it is. JW finishes him off with his AWP. 10-1 is your score. And Fnatic, I wouldn't have predicted that this early on in the game that we'd already see Fnatic on double figure rounds.
No, crazy stuff there. Your two key moments there. At the end when I said it wasn't over because it was Shox.
Yeah.
It was, yeah. Unfortunately. And then SF had he got the entry frag, and then he had a second shot up towards the balcony. And he's got the Galil. It would have to have been a headshot or it would have to have been something special to have made it count. But had he landed that something special, then it would have opened up the site before the reinforcements came from Fnatic. None of that happened. It's 10-1, and Epsilon are on a CZ and Nade round. So real tough stuff for them. They are, you know, for all intents and purposes, whilst this is a round that they could turn around, they are not hitting their shots. They are not clicking. Lady Luck is not with them at all, and they are finding themselves in a world of trouble. That Molotov does do some damage onto GMX, but JW will push in, gets himself, it was Pronex who helped him out, got that frag onto SF, and now JW and Pronex, as they have done for many a game, have just picked up frag after frag. FXO did get one. Shox is going to come in, and he'll try and make more hay, but he can't, and it'll be 11-1. And Epsilon are sinking without trace.
I don't know if you've been keeping track, but how many times have Epsilon got the bomb down? I don't think it's
once.
Too many. Yeah, I thought it was only once, and that was the round that they won.
And another question, how many times have they gone B?
Yes.
Once.
Exactly. Exactly. So very interesting tactics here coming in from the French, and I'm sure everybody at home is wondering what's going on as we are here in the Gfinity location here at Stratford Copper Box Arena. Certainly enjoying all the Counter-Strike action we've had so far, and we thought this game could be close, but with the phenomenal firepower that Fnatic are showing us here on Inferno, it could be over quicker than we thought. JW is going to pick up GMX there. Sorry, that was Crims who finished him off. And you can see, this is what I love about Fnatic, and even me being new to Counter-Strike can spot these things so easily, is how well this team, even with the addition of these new players, are so easily able to support each other. It looks so obvious that GMX was going to get that frag. But then out of nowhere, we saw another player come in and just you know, completely control the situation. And that's what I love about Fnatic, and that it's been a real key thing that I've spotted for them so far. And you can see that already we've had one casualty for the terrorist side, GMX going down. Sorry, it wasn't GMX who was being supported down. I'm not exactly sure, I do apologize. 6 HP here for Krim, so he's got to be careful if he doesn't want to get taken out by the terrorist heading down towards Banana. And I think they may have heard us, Tosspot, because we said they've only been to B once, and now they're stacking up in that Banana section right now. Krim's making the best decision just to head back onto the site, not peeking too much here, just in case anything does come his way that could be nasty. JW misses his shot, and that's not often there, but of course he can give information now to the rest of his players. What's going on? FXYO opens things up. In comes the smoke grenades. In come Epsilon onto the B bomb site, and let's see if they can successfully get the bomb down here. Krim's on 6 HP. He's going to pick up two absolutely massive kills. Olaf Meister picks up another two himself, and wow, the two former LGV players who have only recently been added to this roster just went absolutely huge.
They did a great job in that B site, and they got a round of applause from the crowd as well. But like, what I can't understand, because we're talking about the amount of times they've gone B, there were no entry nades into that B site. And why? This is Epsilon's map choice. Why pick Inferno if you've got no confidence in your B strats whatsoever? You can't just go A. And that is an interesting conundrum that maybe we'll get a chance to ask them, or maybe we'll get Richard and Scott and Thorin's thoughts on that. As it is 12-1, JW gets himself that opening frag with the AWP. And as you rightly pointed out there, Krims, he only had 6 points of health when he picked up that frag, but it was a vital frag.
He picked up two.
And Olaf Meister then at the end just waited. And it was the waiting. We were in eyes on Olaf Meister, and they didn't know exactly that for sure that he was there or where he was. And it's like Krims was happy to give himself away because he had 6 points of health. Yep. And Olaf Meister was always going to play the role where he had to get the bomb carrier. And that's exactly what he did, and some. Flusher's got himself a kill as well, as we just run out of living French people. As it is just FXYO that's alive. He is waiting patiently for his death. It's your turn to die, FXYO. As he'll poke his head around the corner. Oh, not quite his turn. As he will go around there, and now Pronax will put him out of his misery. 13-1, Fnatic are stomping Epsilon.
Oh, they are indeed. And having a look at the scoreboard there, we can see SF, unfortunately, only 1-14, and GMX not doing too much better. Only 2-14 there with the total frags. But JW, the man of the hour, they have the nickname JW Best, and he's definitely proving it here. 21-7-6 for him. Really impressive performance. And I thought it would be close, and I thought there would be a standout player. Unfortunately, I called it wrong, and with the looks of things, it's not close at all. But he's definitely been the standout player. Of course, we cannot take anything away from the rest of the Fnatic roster here. They have really shown us what they can do on the main stage. So, as we said, last round of the first half, round number 15, in we go. And the terrorists are just trying to pick up every single thing they can. They have been able to buy armor and rifles, but it's not sitting pretty for them too much, obviously, with only one round on the board out of 14 attempts so far. And here we go. Let's see where they're going to push with this one. The bomb is still actually back towards T-spawn, just at the bottom of Banana, as you can see, and Pronax up with Shocks by the looks of things. Any second here, over towards the balcony area in apartments. Shocks gets flashed, and he's going to go down quickly, and that's lovely teamwork coming in from Fnatic. SF is going to try and do some damage back, but it's not going to do a whole lot. Pronax is taking down to 44 HP, but he's feeling so confident right now, he's going to challenge anyway. Goes down to 16, and he's just going to back away from that into pit. Rightly so for him. It's a 4-on-3 situation as things stand. FXYO has gone down, and GMX making his way up Banana here. He's going to trade out that kill ill for an M4A1, which of course is a very simple and clever decision indeed to get that more powerful rifle in his hands. Backing away from Banana now though, and as we can see from the CT side, we've got one player on B, which I believe is actually Flusher at the second. JW here and Pronax watching A, and we've also got Olaf Meister, I believe, rotating through CT spawn. Is he going to come through arches, or what's he going to do? We can see that the bomb's going to be making its way over towards A. Kiyoshima gets the entry frag. JW is going to respond. He's got that AWP out. Not going to work for him, though, but there's only 5 seconds left on the clock. They've got to get that bomb down quick. Olaf Meister hasn't realized that player there. Now he has. And he picks up two to finish it off. Gets the defuse for his hard troubles. And 14-1 is going to be your score at the halftime mark.
Really interesting stuff there. There were some firsts for Epsilon in that last round. The second time they got the bomb, but it was the first time they actually faked going on to B. Yeah. They got the kill on Crims, and they're like, oh, we could maybe just walk up Banana and force them to move some players around. Exactly. It's exactly what they did, and they came back around. Just stuff that Epsilon hasn't done kind of way outlists what Epsilon have done in that half. Crazy stuff. Fnatic probably can't believe their luck that that's what they went up against from a team who just beat NIP. Mm. So we'll see. Fnatic now on the pistol round. T side will be thinking, God, if we win this, we can close out the game. They're on 14-1. They need just two more rounds. This is simple maths. Even I could do it. Just two more rounds to win the match. As they do pick themselves up the first frag. It's FXO that goes down. And we'll see if Epsilon have much to offer in this second half. Again, Fnatic have moved the bomb back now. And they're going to lead with JW if he can assert an opening on towards that B side. He pushes in, he's got reinforcements, and the nade will do the work for him. JW goes down. Pronex does then finish off on Kiyoshima, but they will quickly rotate out, and they're going to find action very soon in the shape of GMX as he sits waiting for incoming tees, and he mows them down one by one, and now has just one Fnatic player left standing. It's Pronex, who will get mowed down to complete the hat-trick for GMX, and Epsilon are on the board, and they are going to have to deliver a perfect second half. Now remember, against NIP, Epsilon were down 11-4 at halftime, and they did turn that one around. So if you believe that lightning might strike twice, that the Easter Bunny is alive, and that Father Christmas will give you that PlayStation 6 you've been asking for, then it might just happen for Epsilon.
It might just happen indeed. I wouldn't put it past them to get some more rounds on the board here and form some form of comeback, as they are on the more favored side. And we saw them do it, as you mentioned earlier on, against NIP. But still, I think with that crazy lead, with Fnatic only needing two more single rounds here in the second half alone, I think it's just a little maybe too much for them. Shocks is going to start things off here onto JW. He does take some damage and he's going to get knocked down to 25 HP. Still looking good here for Epsilon. Olaf Meister does manage to get one, and of course the objective here for the T's was to try and get that bomb down as soon as possible, just to give them some extra money in the bank. Didn't quite work though. They were able to take down GMX and I think FXO as well, so that's obviously going to force them to rebuy. But 14-3 is going to be your score here already into the 18th round.
Yeah, for Fnatic, they can take their time. They don't need to force anything. They'll get some CZs, and they'll make sure that come that first buy round, they will be fully loaded. So let's see what they'll do here. Looks like they'll split one through the middle and four outright, so they won't pressure Epsilon. But what's different here is Epsilon have a very deep and passive B defense. They know nothing at the moment on those two players on B. And that was what was the big difference between what Fnatic offered. But here we go. FXO walking in a Fnatic steam train as two of them were going through towards the spawn. SF got himself the kill into Olaf Meister, but Pronex will now push in. He's walked past another player, and can't believe this round. Everyone's walking past each other. SF now is going through. We've got two Fnatic players left up and a bomb plant to contend with. Pronex in his 12 points of health against four Epsilon players, but regardless, there is money in the bank, and there will be the defuse. So, crazy round, but 14-4 the score.
Yeah, exactly. A bit hectic, but kind of would expect that. And Fnatic now getting that bomb down, looking pretty, and they are going to be able to buy up here. So in come the AK-47s, and JW already picking up that AWP. So let's see what he can do with it. The CTs of Epsilon deciding not to go for an AWP here as of yet. So we will see what that is going to do in terms of round number 19. In we go. Are Fnatic going to be able to take their first round on the board here in the second half? Or are Epsilon going to really start to mount this comeback and get some more rounds on the board? We're about to find out here. JW just trying to peek with that AWP, and there we go. That's why they call him JW Best. Easy shot there onto GMX while he makes it look easy anyway. He's going to pick up the bomb, and let's see where they start to head with this. Could be the real good opening here for Fnatic, getting that early frag, taking out that player on A, which is of course going to start to split things up here for the CTs. And let's see where they're going. They're looking like they're favoring apartments here. They've got good control of it as things stand. And I believe Shox is going to be the only person initially in apartments to challenge them. And there's the man of the hour who we've just called out. He's up top here in apartments, and he's going to have two players in JW and Olaf Meister just to his bottom left. In comes the chicken. Blusher gets two huge frags down to SF and Kiyoshima, shutting them down. He's going to get eventually stopped by FXO in his tracks. But that's going to make things onto a 4-on-2 an advantage. And as soon as Fnatic have got these rifles in their hands, they're just pretty much dominating. Shox is going to try and put a stop to that, though. He's going to find Crims there, and he's going to be able to pick up that second player. Runs out of ammunition and has to switch to his CZ75. He's on 16 HP. It doesn't matter anyway, because he's getting knocked out. The bomb's going to get planted. And it's all in the hands of FXO. Lovely frag. and onto JW, taking him out with a headshot. Pronax on 19 HP, Olofmeister only on 42. In comes the second frag here from FXJO. Is this going to be a crazy one versus three? Defuse and clutch, we're about to find out. He's on the bomb site. Shots are going down. Pronax has to be so careful because he's only on 19 HP. And he somehow gets the frag. And I think that's just about finished off Epsilon.
Two really interesting plays in that one. First of all, Shox. He sat waiting as he came out of the house, and he sat waiting. Two players went past. At any given time, you think, right, the first, you wait for the second goes past. But he waited just those 5 seconds longer, as a pro would know to do,
yeah.
And the third went past. So then you're thinking, right, he's going to pop his head out, and he's going to get three kills. He missed the opening shot, unlike Shox there, and in the end was ineffective in terms of, you know, stopping that attack. Then Pronax was fortunate that the other man that was in the pit with him had died. And thus, the FXJO didn't think that the second man would be in the pit. He was looking for other places for him. So, interesting end to that round, and great play from Pronax. 15-4 in favor of Fnatic. They have 11 match points, but they are staring down the barrel, having lost the entry frag on this one to Shox, who will push in. And they've lost the second frag as well. GMX will get it. It's Crims that's down. Olofmeister too late to chase out the retreating CTs, as we're on 3 versus 5, and Fnatic gonna have to deliver, and they still do have quite the firepower. And this is maybe that point Thorin was saying, that with two players down, the three that are left standing are still Olaf, Promeister, and Olaf, Pronax, and Flusher. And that is what they're capable of. Headshot comes in, but through the smoke, FXJO dispatches of Olofmeister. In coming up towards that B site now, as SF and Kiyoshima will see action. And as they push in, a lot of damage done to Flusher. He's down to 9 points of health, and the rotation is definitely on. The nades come in from Fnatic. They look to push out the defending Epsilon players. The first nade does its job, but there's not much left on Pronax. It will be 15-5. Epsilon get themselves another round. They only have to win another 10.
Only have to win another 10, yeah. Well, we'll see. You know, they mounted a crazy comeback earlier on, as we've pointed out many times, but with Fnatic on match point here, it's going to be very difficult indeed. Of course, with the rounds that they do have in the bag here for Fnatic, they're not going to be too worried whatsoever about taking an eco. We see a couple of, four P250s, in fact, coming into play here from the T side. And let's see what they can do here. FXJO, he had that crucial pick earlier on in the last round on JW with the AWP battle there going over towards mid. SF is going to start things off. It looks like it's going to be a B rush coming in very, very quickly indeed. Lots of frags going down. SF picks up 3 to start it off. Let's see if he can get 4. And he does actually indeed. Kiyoshima getting the 5th there, I do believe. But strong work indeed. I know it was an eco, and Fnatic did pretty much just rush it as quickly as they could. But 15-6 is going to be your score, round number 22.
15-6, Fnatic will CZ up this round, and they will make sure that when they go on to the next one, they're fully armed. So double save for them as they will push in. From Epsilon's perspective, they might be feeling a little bit of confidence coming back to them. But with every frag like that, with every opportunity that they get, they will be building in confidence. They will be acclimatizing themselves to this stage, and we'll see whether they can mount what would be a spectacular comeback. We have had one draw already, which was Fnatic I by POW finishing at 15-15. Remember, it's a round robin group stage, so draws are possible. No overtimes at this stage. Bomb has gone down in on A from Fnatic, though, as they will lie in wait for Epsilon to come in. It's a 3-on-3, is SF will be the first to come in from that spawn side. Kiyoshima coming from the opposite. And Olofmeister just jumps in the back, puts a headshot on Kiyoshima, and we're only 2 frags away from Fnatic taking the round. Shox opens up with the first. It's now all on Shox for Epsilon. He's going to get the second frag, and will go through. It's Flusher that's alive. He'll come from the back. Shox will get himself the hat trick. Beautiful play from Shox, but too little, too late. And Fnatic have won by 16 rounds to 6.